Welcome, Cobra Kai fans. In this episode, we're going to talk about what's next for
Mike fucking Barnes.
I have a huge Mike Barnes prediction, so let's get right to it. In season 5, it seems like the Mike Barnes character left way more questions than answers. When Sean Kanan made the public announcement on social media that he will be appearing in Cobra Kai season 5 and reprising his role after 30 plus years, it left everyone in a frenzy, including myself. The biggest theory floating around at the time was that he was going to join in Terry's crusade after Terry made this popular statement.
So worry about a thing.
I'm sure I can dig up an old friend or two to help out with Cobra Kai while you deal with your legal problems.
You're gonna regret this.
Yep, that was when Mike Barnes' name was popping up everywhere. Well, that didn't happen in season 5. But what we really found out was that Mike Barnes is a proud owner of a furniture store, married, and pretty much living a quiet life. That is, until Daniel LaRusso paid him a visit and, well, let's say his life turned around for the worst. Daniel's little visit cost Barnes his furniture store being burnt to the ground, apparently by Terry Silver. Or did Terry Silver have someone do it for him, like Snake and Dennis? You gotta wonder if those guys are still creeping around. I don't think Terry would do it himself, considering there would be security cameras all around the premise, and he's highly intelligent. It also seems like Mike Barnes' marriage has fallen apart thanks to LaRusso. Okay guys, I have to stop here for a second. If you stuck with me up to here so far, I want you to keep sticking with me until the end. I have a major plot twist, because I ain't believing any of this. So for now, let's talk about the most popular theory and the one that would make most sense to the audience. And that is, Barnes could join Miyagi-Do and prepare the students for the Sekai Taikai, considering he is a former national champion with tons of tournament experience. Makes a lot of sense, don't it? But they already have three senseis, Daniel, Chosen, and Johnny. Yes, I agree he can train them. But if you guys haven't watched my other videos and learned anything, that's what the creators of the show want you to believe. It's an illusion to throw you off. It's too predictable. And when it makes that much sense, people, please don't fall for it. Is this entire show really going to be based on everyone joining Miyagi-Do? Being redeemed? And living happily ever after? I think not. Mike could simply sell his Rembrandt that he stole from Terry Silver's house and reopen another furniture store. And that's the last we see of him. But it won't be the last we see of him. There is a reason why Mike Barnes only appeared in 2 episodes. And it's to build his character up. You know that old saying? Okay guys, are you still with me? Now, it's time for the plot twist. Now remind you, this is a very debatable topic. But here's how I see it. If you don't agree with me, that's fine. We are all here to have fun.
Don't be a pussy. Join.
Let's go back to the Karate Kid Part 3 and the 50% claim.
Any questions?
You remember on the phone you said that if I come down here and I beat this LaRusso kid in the All Valley Tournament, that you give me 25% ownership in your new dojos? Which I think is more than generous. But I've been giving this some thought. For me to do my absolute best, which is what I want to do for you, I'm afraid I'm going to need 50%.
Ooh, 50%.
Well, I don't know if I can afford more than 35.
I understand. I guess I better get going. It's nice meeting everybody.
Hey. Do you fight as hard as you negotiate?
Harder.
You got your 50%.
And I get that in writing.
By noon today.
He says if he beats this LaRusso kid, he gets 50% of the dojo. But was it really predicated on winning? We still don't know that entirely, but I have a treat for you guys. Sean Kanan is a regular guest on my podcast, and I asked him the same question.
But here's another interesting thing I kind of want to know if you can like clarify for me. Terry Silver hired you to beat Daniel at the All Valley and promised you 50% ownership of the dojos. But was it 100% predicated on winning?
It's an excellent question.
Yeah.
That is an excellent question.
Yeah, I'm dying to
remember,
know.
Mike did say, so if I beat this LaRusso kid
yeah.
in the All Valley tournament,
yeah,
I get, and I think Terry, what did he offer him, 20% or some bullshit like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, like it was a low number,
Mike was
25.
Like, I don't think so. Now, yeah. Mike, not the smartest, tool in the shed, right?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
He didn't ask for 51%. He asked for 50%.
50.
So even if he won, he's not going to have controlling interest, you know? I mean, we're talking about a guy that got baffled by a kata. So, I don't know.
Huh. Interesting. Yeah, I always...
By the way, I will provide a link down below to that interview. Please check it out. Okay, now we're on to something. Let's go to Cobra Kai Season 5, Episode 3.
I can see that. Look, Daniel, the only thing I can think of is that back in the day, Silver had this shady-ass attorney. I mean, this guy was totally off the books, right? As a matter of fact, he did my contract for me. I mean, what kind of attorney draws up the paperwork detailing the terms of one teenager terrorizing another?
Wait, he made you sign a contract?
I made them put it in writing. The guy did promise me 50% of Cobra Kai.
If people know this contract existed, Silver's reputation would be destroyed. They'd never let Cobra Kai compete again. This is exactly what we need. Tell me you still have it.
Daniel, no way. I mean, I might be able to dig up that attorney's name.
Does he still have a 50% claim of the dojo? Just by listening to it. Heck yeah, he does. Barnes is simply playing everyone, and he's coming for that Cobra Kai dojo. Kind of funny that when he stole the limo, that he knew Chosen, LaRusso, and Lawrence were all going to be at the club. He is on to something. And now that LaRusso re-entered his life, it ignited something in him. Mike has a past that nobody still knows about. For example, where is he from? Who is he trained by? He's unpredictable and a lone wolf, always hungry. And one thing I would also like to add, this show is called Cobra Kai for a reason. Terry and Kreese, unfortunately, won't be around for that much long. Because let's face it, they're getting old. So we need someone to keep the Cobra Kai dojo and the legacy going for generations to come. And who better than
Mike fucking Barnes?
That is it for this episode. What do you guys think? Comment down below and let's hear your theories. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, thanks for watching.